My name's Ivy Mayhew. I'm from Portland, Oregon, and I go to Portland State University. I'm studying for a liberal studies major, and basically that consists of whatever classes I want to take. But originally, when I first started college, I went in undecided. For a living, I create jewelry that I sell. I also host local events in my area where I have other vendors who have small businesses, and we all come together to sell our crafts. And so, yeah, I make earrings, waist beads, bracelets, necklaces, and I can wire wrap rings too, but earrings and necklaces are my specialty. Those are the things that I love the most. My business is called Artsy Ivy, and I like to create very eye-catching, colorful jewelry. One thing that is super specific and kind of important to me is I have a love for tiny little things. For example, like this little Volkswagen car, a whole bunch of different miniature things. And on my earrings, a lot of miniature things are featured. So like I have some mini mushrooms, mini teacups, mini clocks. I love that type of stuff. So I was actually introduced to jewelry making by my grandmother when I was probably around 5 years old. It's one of her hobbies. She never sold her jewelry, but she always had a wide variety of beads and different jewelry supplies. And so yeah, she taught me how to make earrings at first, and then necklaces, and that's where I begun. And then after she taught me, I would submit my work into 4-H, and I would do little competitions and stuff for my jewelry. Probably it's been over 10 years that I've been making jewelry, but since I've been running Artsy Ivy, it's been almost 2 years. One thing that I've learned is finding other creatives that do work in your practice is a super good source for inspiration and just marketing, getting to learn tips from them, getting to share your tips with them. That's something that's super valuable to me. And it's also important to me because, like I was saying earlier, how I host events that feature other artists, marketing and getting to talk to other people is a key thing for those to be able to run, because without vendors, I wouldn't be able to create a market. So, yeah.
What is your creative process when making your jewelry and making them different and unique each time?
Well, I do a lot of shopping around for pendants, and I like to go to thrift stores, like jewelry thrift stores. And honestly, most of the time I don't go in with too much of an idea in my head. I kind of just am like in that moment, see what the vibe is, whatever catches my eye. That's usually what pendants I grab. But something that does really inspire me when it comes to creating my stuff is just like earth itself. So trees, for example, I love the different shades of trees and different plants and flowers. So I like to incorporate those colors into my work. And then just little things that I like tea. I love tea. I'll make like teacup inspired earrings, or since I like books, I'll make book inspired earrings and butterfly inspired earrings. So yeah, just whatever my heart desires, that's what I try to use as my creative direction. Earrings, hands down, are my favorite to make. They're the quickest and easiest for me to make, but I don't know, there's just something about a good earring that really makes me happy. So I would definitely say earrings are my personal preference.
What do you like to do in your free time when you're not running your business or doing schoolwork?
I love to just spend time with my friends and be outside just experiencing life. I like to go to Timbers games. I love to go out to restaurants and try new food. And I love to go on scenic walks. Near where I live, there's a lot of hills, so if you walk up to the top of those during the evening, you can get a really beautiful view of the sunset, which I love to do.
What advice would you like to give for anyone wanting to start their business?
I would say prepare and plan. Do your research before, you know, creating a business. You want to think about marketing, so you want to get your business cards ready. You want to think about who your target audience is. you kind of want to think about, okay, what exactly am I going to be creating? Also, something that's really valuable is if you're going to be starting a business where you ship things, it's super important to stock up on all your shipping supplies before you start. And also, packaging. It's such like an important part of running your small business, because the way things are presented and they look, I think, plays a big role in, you know, how many sales you're gonna get and kind of just the overall vibe and look of like what your whole business is. So yeah, those are my tips. If you have some ideas and stuff that you're passionate about, do it, because like the person that's known you longest in this life is you. You know yourself best, and you're always gonna be your number one supporter. So, you know, if you feel passionate about something, do it. Believe in yourself, because you're a bad bitch and you can. And also just surrounding yourself with people that also believe in you and make remind you to believe in yourself. That's also something that I believe is super important. So, but yeah, that's all I gotta say. This has been Artsy Ivy, and thank you for listening to me.